allows Manis Zeman vast experience in the field of logistics, not only in Greece, but internationally. It is no coincidence that he is chairman of the National Logistics Council of Greece. It's my honor to introduce Mr. Zilliaskopoulos Thanasis, the chairman of the National Logistics Council of Greece. Mr. Zilliaskopoulos.
Thank you, Mr. Floras. Good morning to everybody. I guess good afternoon in China. Ciao, Wu Hao, I would say. It's an honor to be in this very distinguished panel. And this is, I believe, a good opportunity to boost again all the relationships between China and Greece, especially after in the meta-COVID era. If I may, I would like to share a short presentation so that I can communicate certain things much easier. Can I do that, Mr. Floras?
Yes, of course, of course. You may share.
Okay, great. I'm the chairman of the National Logistics Council, which is an organization that with industry and government and educational and research institutions to promote Greece as a logistics hub and Greece as a better place to do business in logistics. I'm also professor of logistics and transport at the University of Thessaly. Now, we said many times in this presentation, actually it's even the topic of this presentation, that Greece is the gateway to Europe. I think there is no, everybody understands that in a different way, but if we ask why Greece is a gateway to Europe, which it's not only to Europe, to Middle East, North Africa, and the Black Sea region. It's obviously some, I'm going to take some of the slides from Mr. Vavakidis, with who we collaborated when I was the chairman of Trenosem. So I'm entitled to the copyright to some of this, of his slides. In terms of being the crossroads and the connectivity of Greece to all this region, which includes, like I said, at least three continents and a very large part of the global population and the global GDP, people that have really the resources and consumers that can really spend. And Greece is in the middle of this region, very well connected, direct connections to all major ports of Southeast Asia, India, East Africa, and of course to the ports in our neighborhood, including the Adriatic. We have world-class infrastructure, roadways, railways, ports, airports. It was mentioned by the Secretary General before that we have 145 ports. It's not only the port of Piraeus, but we have 145 ports, each one of them with a different value, from Port of Alexandroupolis, which is much closer and with a good railway connection to the Black Sea ports, all the way to Gumenitsa with good connections to the ferries and the ports of Italy and the North Adriatic area. Highly populated hinterland. In one day from Greece, your freight, your cargo can reach 80 million people. In 2 days, almost 200 million people and 350 million people in 3 days. So like Mr. Vavakidis said in one of his slides before, in 4 days, practically you can reach the whole Europe, including the major parts of Russia, Black Sea, Turkey, and North Africa. This didn't happen by accident. Of course, the geography of Greece helps, but a lot of work has been done in the last 10 years actually to promote Greece as being the logistics hub. And still a lot needs to be done, but we believe that we have an environment, we provide an environment in Greece, a logistics environment, which can really support any business and distribution activities. So if you need to distribute in Europe or in all this vast area, a distribution facility in Greece could become available to you and all the world-class infrastructure and connectivity to be able effectively in very short and in a very efficient way to reach all these global markets. We have a very mature logistics industry with almost 4 million square meters of warehousing, state-of-the-art technology and equipment, and very well educated and skilled personnel, educated human resources. Also, we talked about that in the past. And a favorable business climate. We have, as a logistics council, we are developing a strategy that can promote very streamlined and simplified licensing in every business activity, and also incentives policy, like the ministers said in the beginning. Very quickly, I'm going through some slides. This is, I stole it from Mr. Vambakidis. We are at the crossroads. That's our geography, the closest EU area and Euro area port in after exiting the Suez Canal. Direct lines, like I said before, direct connections to every major port in Southeast India and also increasingly East Africa. Even in the first, when it was called to Unbelt to Our Road initiative, we were both in the crossroads of the sea and the land connection. Even the trains that are coming through the Central Asia and Istanbul will come through Greece. So it's even the land bridge is really coming through Greece. So it is, we are in the crossroads in that sense. Also, this is from an older presentation, but the data is still current. We provide a faster connection. Effectively, instead of going around, which is gonna take you at least 10 days longer, you can reach even Hamburg 5 days faster if you come through Piraeus. So going through Gibraltar, around Gibraltar, it takes time. So we provide very efficient options now as a country to, and very good infrastructure to be able to do that. This is a historical photo. This is the first train back in 2013 that departed from Kosko to Pardubice in central, in Czech Republic, with Hewlett Packard products, and that was under the presence of the prime ministers of Greece and China. So Greece has a mature logistics industry. This is very important for your business. If you are interested in setting up shop in Europe and the whole Middle East area, Greece provides really state-of-the-art facilities and services to be able to do that. And like we said before, we utilize, we're part of the 10T, all the European, the trans-European networks in everything from railroads to highways, and of course, energy and telecommunications. And this is another slide from Mr. Vambakidis. We provide also this connection to all this area through feeder services from the Greek ports. This is of course from the port of Piraeus. So if your products come to Greece, they can be distributed very efficiently. So value-added logistics services, we have personnel to provide, we have the capabilities and the know-how to do this business. In terms of our strategy, actually, the National Logistics Strategy of Greece, the very first objective out of the four objectives is really to promote Greece as a gateway. We continue to improve our presence in this region. And of course, to improve the national logistics, the green logistics, we're very sensitive to that. And of course, we have started a major initiative on the digital transformation of the logistics industry. I'm not gonna say too much about this. There are certain initiatives from Thriasio to Bono, major logistics park are being really provided under concession from the Greek government. So it's a good opportunity really even to set up business in these major facilities. But the digital transformation is taking place, it's happening. The Resilience and Recovery Fund from the European Union is being channeled in this direction, and logistics is going to benefit a lot from digital custom to digital documentation, all the way to automated warehousing and distribution services. And human resources, we should not underestimate. Greeks are really educated people, highly skilled, and can provide really high-end services. So in conclusion, why should you set up your distribution and value-added business in Greece? Well, we have this specialized, like I said, logistics service providers, world-class transport infrastructure, strong logistics base for e-commerce. This is increasing. It's getting better and stronger. Excellent connectivity. You can reach 350 high-end consumers in less than 3 days. Greeks are skilled in logistics, pro-business government. And of course, finally, before I close, nowhere in the world you can find your office will look like this. So I'm sure Mr. Anastasiades can have offers on office spaces that look like this. So thank you very much.